Hello viewers, welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to look at the most exciting part of the report in which Microsoft has provided us different options to apply filters. So these are the different types of filters that we have in Power BI, which are the automatic filters, manual filters, include and exclude filters, drill down, cross drill filters, drill through filters, URL filters, and pass-through filters. Subscribe to my channel to get alerts on my new videos on technical front. Let's get started with the filters one by one. I'll be using the retail analysis sample PBX file, which is provided by Microsoft, to explain on the filters. First, let's look at the automatic filters. In the district monthly sales page, when you look at this visual, which is the total sales variance percentage by the fiscal month, it has got two fields. One is the fiscal month along the x-axis and the total sales variance percentage along the y-axis. These two fields appear in the filter pane as well. Suppose if I remove the fiscal month field from the x-axis, it gets removed in the filters pane as well. Suppose if I add a new field, say fiscal year, to the x-axis, it gets added to the filter section as well. This kind of filtering that happens automatically is called automatic filters. Next comes the manual filters. Let's say I want only these two fields in my visual, but I need to view the visual by applying the filter on city field. In that case, I can drag and drop the city field directly into the filters pane. This type of filter is called manual filter. As and when I apply filter on the city, I can see the changes in my visual. So this is called manual filter. The third filter that we are going to look at is the include and exclude filters. Let's say I'm analyzing this visual. I want to understand the sales variance for the month of March and April only. So I'll click on March and April and then I'll add them to include. So you can see included two here in the filters pane where March and April got included here. Even if I change the values in the other filter conditions, I can still see the value for March and April only, whichever is applicable. This kind of filtering is called include filter. Same is the case with exclude filter. So to show you how the exclude filter works, let me first remove this included one. Now I'll click on the bar whichever is required and then I'll select exclude. So these months will be excluded from my visual and my visual is going to show me the statistics of the remaining months. This is how the include and the exclude filter works. Next comes the drill down filter. So what do you understand by the term drill down? It just means that you want to understand the next level of details for a particular field or parameter. So consider this visual where you have the store number name along the x-axis and this year's sales along the y-axis. Say for example, I do not want to view the visual by store number name. Rather, I want to view the sales details of each district. Then I'll identify whichever district has got the maximum sales and I'll drill down into that particular district to see the stores for performance. So to do this drill down, I'll need two fields in my x-axis. So in my x-axis, I'll have the district field first followed by the store number name. Now you can see that this particular visual is now refreshed with district along the x-axis and this year's sales along the y-axis. So next, I need to drill down from district to store number name, for which I'll first need to enable the drill down feature. The moment you add two fields to x-axis, this drill down icon gets added automatically. So all that you have to do is just click on it to turn it on. So once you turn it on, just click on a particular district, and it is going to drill down to the store number names of that particular district. So you can have a view of all the store number names relating to the district that you have selected. Now, if you want to go back to the main visual where you want to see the display of all the districts, all that you have to do is click on the drill up, which is going to show you the first level of the visual. And this is how the drill down filter works. Now let's look at the cross drill filter. This is yet another interesting filter that comes as part of the drill down on the same report page. So I'm going to work on the same district monthly sales page. Click on the visual that you would want. So in this case, I'm going to click on this year's sales by district. After clicking on this particular visual, go to format and then go to edit interactions. You will be able to see 2 to 3 features at the top right corner of each and every visual. Something like this, which will say filter, highlight and none. You can see these features at the top of each and every visual. In some cases, the highlight will not be available. Otherwise, you will be able to see the filter and the none option. So these features are the ones that is going to help me with this cross drill filter. What I'm going to do now is choose whatever visual that I would want to refresh based on my selection in this particular visual. So I'll say like I want this filter to be enabled. So whenever I choose this filter, this should get refreshed automatically. Then I want this also to be enabled and I don't want this. So I'm going to give it to be none and I don't want this visual also. So I'll give it to be none. So now I'm done with my selection process. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to select the bar of my visual. You can see that as and when I click that particular bar, only these two visuals get refreshed, whereas these two do not change because I've given none here, which means this filter in my visual is not going to affect these two visuals. And this is how the cross drill filter works. Next comes the drill through filters. So this filter is appropriate when I want to drill through from one page to another. That is from the district monthly sales to another page. To explain you on the drill through filter, I've created a new page called sales data where I have added the table visualization and my columns are the store number name, territory, city, and total sales. My objective here is that in the district monthly sales, when I click on a particular store number name in this chart, it has to drill through that particular bar and show me the data in the sales data page. So for that, we first need to enable the drill through feature. So I'm going to drill through from this page to this page, which is the sales data page. So my source page is going to be the district monthly sales and my target is going to be the sales data page. So the setting has to be applied on the target page. So to get the drill through feature enabled, I have to go to the target page, which is the sales data page. There, go to visualizations and we have to add a drill through field here. So my drill through is going to be based on the store number name. So let me add the store number name field in the drill through field. So once added, you can see that field here in the section of the target page. So what you have to do is just go to the source page, which is the district monthly sales, and there click on any particular bar. You'll be able to see an option which is drill through on the sales data page. If you click on that, the sales data page is going to show me the details of that particular bar. Let's say I want to drill through based on the store number name, which is 19. So drill through sales data. My sales data page is going to show me the details of the 19 store number name. You can see a left arrow here. So this is going to take me to the previous page of the drill through feature. So what I have to do is control plus by clicking this left arrow is going to take me to the district monthly sales page. And this is how the drill through filter works. To share the Power BI reports, we can publish them in Power BI service. So in the Power BI service, each page of the report will have its own unique URL. So we can use URL filters in the Power BI service, which I'll be covering in my upcoming videos. Pass-through filters are also used in Power BI service. To give you a brief overview of the pass-through filter, it will be like a question and answer format to apply the filters. Keep a tab on my next set of Power BI videos. Thanks for watching. See you soon with my next set of technical videos.